If you see a website design that looks amateurish or DIY, it's almost a guarantee that spacing has a lot to do with that. And while a lot of things do need a consistent, even amount of space between them, applying that to everything on your website through your theme or a framework is one of the mistakes I see made most often. Spacing isn't just about having enough white space on the page. It can build structure, organize information, create hierarchy, and help draw the user's eye exactly where you want it. And it is literally impossible to do all of these things if you just use one consistent gap value in between all your elements. In this video, we're going to improve the look and the functionality of three different sections just by taking a more thoughtful approach to our spacing. If polishing up your designs is something you'd like to do, then stick around and let's get started. So the first layout we're gonna look at is this hero section from a website I built not long ago. I went ahead and recreated this all here in Figma because it's gonna make it a little bit easier for us to push all the pixels around. So essentially what we have here is a two column layout. Over on the left column is all the information about the artist and the show, and on the right column is just a photo of the artist. But you can see here where all the information is, I've just used equal spacing in between each one of these lines of text and buttons. Just imagine that I had a container here and I applied some kind of gap in between each one of these that was just an equal gap value. Now this design isn't terrible, but I think we can make it a whole lot better if we're a little bit more intentional with our spacing. So let's go ahead and just make a copy of this here. And we're going to start working with some auto layouts to group information together. One of the huge roles that spacing plays is with proximity. When things are grouped together, we understand them to be related, and when they're further apart, we know that there's less of a relation between them. With everything on this screen right now equally spaced out from each other, it's hard to tell what information goes with what. I think the first thing I notice here is this little headline that says date and time above the actual date and time. Because these things are spaced out the same as everything else on the page, you can't really tell that this is a label for this date and time, or that this is a label for the prices of the ticket. So let's go ahead and take care of that first. I'm just gonna grab these two elements. I'm gonna press Shift A, which will create an auto layout, and this will let us just have a little bit better control of the spacing. I'm gonna go ahead and bring this all the way down to zero, since there is some line height with both of these pieces of text. And I'll do the same thing over here, Shift A, and we'll bring this spacing down to zero. Now, of course, we need to space these out equally in between these things again. And now we can see we've already made an improvement if we zoom out here. Now it's easier to tell that this date and time label goes with the date and time. If you compare this version here and this version here, I think you're going to agree that this one here that doesn't have consistent spacing is actually a much better look. But I think we can take this even a bit further. The big title you see here, which is actually the H1 of the page, is followed by a subheadline that kind of describes the band in case people aren't familiar with the name. So let's go ahead and group these two things together by changing their relationship through proximity. We're going to go ahead and grab both of these elements, Shift A, and we'll go over here and maybe this time we'll work with 8 pixels of spacing in between them. I usually work off of an 8-point grid, so I'm doing multiples of 8, so you'll see me use that throughout this demo. Again, if we zoom out here, I think we've made another huge improvement here. We can see the name of the band here and then the subheadline here. But here we can tell that this information is more closely related because it's grouped together. They're in closer proximity to each other, so we know they kind of go together. Now here at the bottom of the layout, we actually have information about buying tickets, more information, and discounted group rates. All of this are kind of like the next steps or actions somebody could take. So I think these actually need to be related as well. I'm gonna go ahead and group my buttons together here, click on the buttons and this text, and again, press Shift A to create an auto layout. These currently have 25 pixels between them, but I'm gonna do another 8-pixel gap like we did up here, just to bring this discounted group rates closer into our buttons. We'll go ahead and zoom out again here, and we can see now you can tell that these discounted group rates is kind of related to these buttons here. At this point, we've ended up with 3 groups. We have the actions down here, this kind of metadata about the date and time and ticket prices, and then information about the artist. Now I actually think we can use equal spacing between these to really finish out this design. I'll go ahead and select each of these 3 groups. Again, press Shift A to make an auto layout, and we'll just make sure that everything's evenly spaced. I'm gonna go with 40 pixels of space in between these 3 different groups here, just so we can stay consistent with our 8-point grid. Let's take a closer look here to the before and after. This is the before version where everything is equally spaced, and this is the after version where we've used some grouping of information and actually played with the space to make things a little bit easier to read. I'll swap back and forth here a few times so you can see the difference we made. It is subtle, but this second version is a whole lot easier to read and easier for your brain to comprehend what's actually going on in this page. Now that first example had quite a bit of design to it, but you can run into the same problem when you're just talking about text on a page. I see this happen a lot inside of blog posts, so I've created something like that here inside of this drawing. Here you can see we have headlines, followed by paragraphs of text, then another headline, and paragraphs of text. In between each set of paragraph and headline, we have equal spacing. In fact, I already created this inside of an auto layout. You can see we have 40 pixels between each one of these groups of information. But the problem with a layout like this is it seems like these headlines in the middle are just kind of floating out in space. They're neither grouped with the information above it or below it, so it's hard to tell at a glance what this information is related to. So let's go ahead and make a copy of this as well, and we'll work on being a little bit more intentional with our spacing. We know that the headline for step one and the text for step one are closely related, so let's go ahead and grab both of those things and hit Shift A to do an auto layout. And instead of 40 pixels of space, I'm going to change this down to 16. Now you see we have our 16 in between the headline and the text, which makes these seem more connected. Let's go ahead and repeat that for our next set here. We'll change this as well to 16. And for our last one down here, Shift A to make an auto layout and change it to 16. Now just to make this a little bit more dramatic and so you can really see this effect in action, I'm going to go ahead and bump this up from 40 to 72, and we'll zoom out and look at both of these side by side. The version on the left has everything equally spaced, and like I said before, it's hard to tell where the headlines belong with the paragraphs. But here in this second version, we can quickly tell that all of this information goes with step one, all of this information goes with step two, and so on. Of course, nobody wants to set up all that spacing manually and add margin to all of your headlines or paragraphs, so there's actually a cool little trick to fix this. I use this all the time inside of things like blog posts where we have long form content, and I can kind of predict the patterns that will appear. Here you can see I've kind of recreated that initial design where everything is equally spaced, but I'm going to jump in here into the customizer. Here inside the additional CSS, I'm going to go ahead and paste in this selector I have that kind of wraps all this text. I'll usually do that inside of my blog post template. Whatever div is going to hold all the information for my blog post, I'll go ahead and put some kind of unique identifier on it. In this case, we're just going to use content wrapper. Here I'm going to do a P, a plus symbol, and then H2. With that selector built, I can go ahead and put margin top, and we'll just do something exaggerated like 300 pixels. So you can see it's gone ahead and targeted these H2s and put 300 pixels of top margin on it. The neat thing about doing this P plus the H2 is it's not affecting this first one since it doesn't have a paragraph before it. You'll see if I cut this out of here, that first one doesn't get affected because obviously we wouldn't want to add the top margin to that headline, only when we're talking about headlines they're butted up against paragraphs. Now, of course, you're going to have more than just an H2, so a safer way to do this is to use the is selector, and we can do H2, H3, and we'll do this all the way through H6. Close our parentheses here, and no matter if we put an H2 through an H6 on the page, we can actually target those things and add a little bit of extra top margin. Now, obviously, 300 pixels isn't great, but if we did something like 2M, we can make this space big enough that we can tell this information is separated, and that actual gap in between these things will scale proportionally based on the headline size, because obviously your H3s and H4s are going to be smaller, so they don't need quite as big of a gap. In this instance, it's about keeping proportions. Let's go ahead and hop back into Figma here, and we're going to take a look at one more example. This equal spacing phenomenon is something I see a lot inside card designs like this. You can see there's equal spacing between this image here and the first line of text, the same spacing in between the headline and the text, and the same spacing between the text and the call to action. Similar to what we just saw in the blog post, this makes it look as if this text is just kind of floating in no man's land. It doesn't feel anchored or actually connected with any of the other information on the page. Thankfully, this is a really easy one to fix. We'll just go ahead and grab this headline and the text underneath it, hit Shift A, and change this auto layout from 24 pixels in between it to 8 pixels. Now, I think this did improve it, but I'm not sold on this actually being finished. Because the amount of space, which is 8 pixels here and 24 here, isn't a huge difference between the two, it almost feels a little bit disjointed in this instance. I think what this design could actually benefit from is having more spacing from the bottom of this paragraph here to the call to action. So instead of 24, let's change that to 40. That actually puts it back in line to where it was on the card before. Now we can actually see that the headline and text is connected, and it's given some more space around our call to action, which actually helps draw your eye into it. This is a great use of negative space to really draw in your attention. Now let's go ahead and take a look at these two different designs back to back. Once you have a big group of these, like these cards we see here, which kind of look like blog cards, you can see how this gets a little bit overwhelming on your eye. Nothing is very connected and it's hard to know exactly where to look. But as we switch to the redesigned version, which just takes away some of the space between the headline and the text and adds that space down here between the text and the call to action, it makes it a whole lot easier for your eye to figure out what information is what and what you should be looking at next. It might sound a little counterintuitive to vary the spacing between your elements, because you know every designer will tell you that consistency is so important, but it just doesn't work when you use it as a blanket rule and apply it to everything. As you saw me demonstrate in this video, if we're a little bit more intentional with our spacing and vary it up to group information together, we're able to create a better visual hierarchy and create a more polished looking design. What you're really able to do is take a good design and make it look great by just applying a few of these simple techniques. Now, if you enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate a thumbs up. And if you want to make sure to catch the next one, hit subscribe and we'll see you then.